right. Awesome. It's great to be here with you today. Really glad you're joining us for this session. I'm Nick Robinson. I'm a program manager on the eDiscovery and investigations team. And I'm joined by my colleague, Jeffrey Wang, today. We're super excited to talk to you about some of the innovations that we're releasing now to help you with your eDiscovery process around the modern ways users are collaborating. And so some of the challenges that customers have been telling us about for a little bit now, we've really leaned in on, and we've got some exciting innovations to share. So let's go ahead and jump right in and take a look and step through some of this content. So, you know, one of the first things that we think about when we talk to our customers and we look out in the world around us is, you know, the digital transformation that has been taking place, but now is really accelerating due to the requirements around remote work, are putting an interesting pressure on organizations and the, both the employees and also the administrators and the facilitators of those organizations. So of course, data is exploding. We've been seeing that, and we've been seeing data volumes increase, but also the data types are increasing. And so the challenges of understanding, discovering, collecting, reviewing all that content are also increasing as well. And then you layer in the regulation and the regulatory landscape, constantly evolving, continual change there. And there's just a big challenge for organizations to wrestle with, even in light of these other challenges that they're facing with supporting remote work and transitioning to the cloud. And so we hear a lot of customers coming to us and seeing a lot of the things that Advanced eDiscovery can help with, some of the key value props that we're able to deliver and help organizations in light of this data explosion and digital transformation, is really discovering and collecting data where it is. So staying very close to the source content, only taking out the content that you need to remove from the Microsoft 365 security and compliance boundary, and really being able to start to manage those workflows with your native applications in Microsoft 365. So things like legal hold notices, things like review, you can now do natively with the apps, which helps you keep more of that content again in the boundary. And then the third piece that is really helping deliver value for customers is around culling and reducing data using the intelligence baked into the system. And this way you just reduce that overall volume that you're taking out of the system. And so you're reducing costs that come downstream from things like third-party review, but you're also reducing your risk because you're able to kind of keep more of that sensitive content where it should be within the compliance boundary. And so we're seeing some adoption already across industries for scenarios like internal investigations, early case assessment, privacy requests, and even a lot of interest around Freedom of Information Act requests and things like that in the public sector. So some great traction and ways that you can use the capability now to get started. And as I mentioned, when we talked about kind of the modern ways that people are working, one of the scenarios that we see is super common for our customers and that we experience a lot here at Microsoft as well, is this concept of kind of a cross-functional team. And so I just want to step through the scenario around this team to illustrate a bit about kind of what the workflow is like from an end user perspective. You know, a team gets formed up, there's group chats started, there's channels, teams that are created to address specific work streams. And then within those communications, you have users who will share project documents as linked files or attachments, cloud attachments in email or in Teams messages. And really what they are getting to is to be able to quickly kind of co-edit, co-create documents that are relevant to the project. And now these files might be located in a OneDrive for Business location that is related to a project team member, or they might be in a team site or a different SharePoint site that's related to a department. So they could have different homes within the ecosystem, but they all kind of become available and part of this project. And so once these are shared amongst the team, then there's this dynamic dialogue with document views, editing, co-authoring to kind of quickly get to that business outcome. Now, this is great from an end user perspective because I don't have to worry about version control. I don't have to worry about waiting for the version to come across that's been attached to the email, version 1, 2, 3, and my inbox getting filled up with all these attached copies. So there's a lot of benefits, and it's also great from the admin perspective, the organization perspective, because I'm not creating redundant copies of my data, and my users are able to kind of be more effective. But it does create some challenges when it comes to compliance and e-discovery. And so these are some of the things that customers have been telling us about over time that we've been using to guide us in our product investments and the solutions that we're excited to deliver to you today. So some of those challenges that we'd heard are, hey, identifying these locations is tough. You know, I've got the Exchange, the email inbox, and I've got the OneDrive location for my custodians, but also they could be members of various teams. They could be members of various Yammer groups. There's different places that they're going to extend that data footprint, and finding all of those is a challenge. The second piece is these modern data types. So Yammer, Teams, other different ways of communicating and sharing content are becoming more and more prevalent, and that poses a challenge. You have to evolve with that evolution of those data types. The third piece is associating the content that's been shared via these linked files and these cloud attachments. So if I have some content that I know is relevant to my investigation, but I have linked files that are capturing that content, how can I go and collect that content? It's a very arduous process to trace that back today. And then the last piece is I've got all these singular messages in these chats that are taking place in my organization. And going through a high volume of those singular messages to build out that story is time consuming and difficult. It's really hard to get context out of these singular messages. And so I need to be able to review these things in context. And so we've used some of that feedback to help improve and deliver some of the capabilities that we're bringing to advanced eDiscovery today. Now at Ignite, we're announcing kind of three big things in the eDiscovery area. And today's session, we want to go deep on modern attachments and talk about this concept of linked files and collecting that content into your case. We have other sessions covering the API and enhanced collections. You should definitely check those out. But in order to kind of cover more deeply in this modern attachments, I want to illustrate a little bit of how customers are wrangling with this today. So with the traditional solution, there's a number of steps. So I got to go run my search out on my content, start to collect what I think is relevant. Then I got to export those results and run a script on those results. So I'm going to actually start to do some analysis on the export that I've taken from that search. And then I'm going to use the output of that script, the analysis, to go back and manually retrieve the linked documents from that output report. And then finally, then I can go back and merge the exports and update those load files. So you can imagine this is an arduous process, and these things are time sensitive. This isn't something that I have weeks and weeks to handle. I need to be able to respond to these requests in short order. So now what you can do with the new capabilities is actually, if your search is responsive to this particular set of content, we're going to actually collect those linked files for you and make those available as part of the review and as a part of that responsive content. And so to take you through this in more detail, I'm really excited to introduce my colleague, Jeffrey Wang. He's going to walk us through the demo of all this exciting stuff that you'll be able to take advantage of starting soon.
Great. Thanks so much, Nick. As you can tell, modern collaboration brings a good amount of complexity to the eDiscovery process. Today, I'm going to take you through a common early case assessment scenario when we identify, collect, and review for evidence. More specifically, we will highlight the benefits of being able to collect linked attachments and build a story for your review set. So here's the situation. Contoso is following up on a complaint by an employee who believes Irvin is leaking details about a confidential project called Capilano. As an eDiscovery manager, you need to investigate and conduct an early case assessment to determine if Irvin had prior knowledge about Project Capilano. Afterwards, you need to review the content for evidence, and if there's anything that comes to light, you would hand that off to an HR or an HR manager for further investigation. So let's dive right into it. Over here, in a case, you have the ability to add your person of interest and their data sources by simply selecting Add Custodians. Today, we will be adding Irvin, who is suspected of leaking confidential information, as well as Alex, who is the lead engineer for Project Capilano. Over here, we will select their personal mailbox and OneDrive. So in this next page, you have the opportunity to associate additional data locations to your custodians. For today, let's choose to add a couple team channels that Alex is actively engaged in. So over here, we will choose Teams. And in this page, as you can see, we have found all of the team channels that Alex is a member of. For the sake of this case, let's just select the team channel that Alex is actively engaged in during his time working on Project Capilano. And just like that, you've added three team channels to be associated with Alex. Afterwards, simply choose to place Alex and Irvin on hold and complete the process. And there you have it. You've added Irvin and Alex as a custodian as part of your case. Next, once you've added your custodian, you can run a search to retrieve the contents that you're looking for by clicking New Search. So let's give this search a friendly name called Custodian Search. And in this page, let's scope the contents of this search to be just the data sources for Alex and Irvin. And for today, I'm going to start that over. In this next page, we have the option to associate additional locations. But for the sake of the demonstration today, let's skip right ahead to search criteria. Over here, let's insert a quick keyword search for Capilano and finish our search. So once you finish your search, you have the ability to add the results that you found from your search to a review set. Simply select on the search and select Add Results to Review Set, and you'll arrive at this page. Over here, you have the ability to add the results to an existing review set that we've already created called Project Capilano Document Review. Below, you will see additional collection settings and three checkboxes. The first checkbox allows you to bring all versions for SharePoint items. The second checkbox allows you to bring in additional contextual Teams and Yammer messages around any of the messages that were found as a result of a keyword search. And the last checkbox brings in linked or attached content that were found or contained in any of the items that match your keyword search. So today, let's select the Teams and Yammer messages, as well as the linked and attached content. Once you're able to add your contents from your search to a review set, you can see that we thread together Teams messages. In particular, in this instance, we see that Irvin has been asking additional details about Project Capilano, and Alex eventually shares a link to the project spec. Now, in the previous step, you're able to select a checkbox that told the system to collect and retrieve linked attachments. As a result, as you can see here, we've collected those linked attachments and we display them beside all of the team's messages. If we select one of the linked attachments, it becomes very clear that Alex shared the product specifications for Project Capilano. As an eDiscovery manager, I now know for a fact that Irvin had prior knowledge about confidential information related to Project Capilano, and this is enough for me to go ahead, select these items, and either download or export this content to hand it off to an HR manager for further investigation. Now that I have found evidence that confirms Irvin had prior knowledge about Project Capilano, I can either choose to download or export this content and hand this off to an HR manager for further investigation. As an eDiscovery manager, being able to collect and retrieve linked attachments helped me be able to arrive at this conclusion faster and really speaks to the increased time to value of being able to conduct these early case assessment in a quick and efficient manner. With that, I'd like to end our demo and move on to what's next. We have a lot of new features coming out across not just in eDiscovery, as well as other compliance solutions. So I encourage all of you guys to check out our product roadmap and keep an eye out for some of the neat new features that are coming out. Last but not least, you guys can get started today. We offer a free E5 trial through the Compliance Center, where you can try out some of the new features that we just demoed today, as well as other compliance solutions through the Compliance Center, where you can try out some of the new features that we just demoed today, as well as other compliance solutions. So thanks so much for tuning in today, and I look forward to your feedback.